So yes, it will, hasn't it?
Brand new Lamborghini, fuck a cop car. Put a pistol on my hip like I'm a cop.
My last time like pop artist, I did do this thing one, was the fucking February. Now I was supposed to sing it as even XL at one point, but since that was my personal life in the 2009 year, I unfortunately wasn't able to do my summer top 20 ranks for you until now, but don't worry, this year is going to be a good one, I promise. And it's just insane because this whole thing is actually pretty great at the moment. Yeah, I feel really great, the subtitle is really good. Yeah, sure, with 1 week and some of it won't fuck off. But we showed just how great this truck can get. We've got a lot of summer boy songs with some old acts and some acts that have been big this year, being the A game. Yeah, I have no real complaints, like I said before. Really, anything I can do now is same one. Multiply, score, like, share, subscribe, and that's about it. Really, just so we just need any introduction. Let's just get into this, shall we? And before we do, let's get into my top 20 ranks for summer 2020. Yeah, I know it's a bit late. Let's go!
You hate me, hate me, hate me, you hate me.
So they party.
This is when the most boring song of all time. I really, really, really don't like this song in any way possible.
She don't want nobody, she don't need somebody. I'm trying to be with you so you don't be without me.
This is probably the dullest song of the year. I don't know why, but the singing in here just sounds so dull and bored.
Never do you wrong, so tell me why you don't trust me. She don't do this often, she said.
He always feels like he's gonna sleep on this song.
Wanted, therefore you can never judge me. She just...
It does this song down. I feel like with more energetic feeling, this could have been way better, but as I said, it's just so boring. Like, why would anyone listen to this? Like, why? There's no reason. This is one way to use this song in the top 20. At least it's on the worst of the year. You can see some appeal. But this? Really?
Just like me, no, we can't leave without.
Like, who would choose to listen to this song? Who would buy this song? Who would enjoy this song? This is the most dull song ever. And the lyrics aren't anything different.
So in turn, it's just you, Roxanne again.
Roxanne, Roxanne, all she wanna do is party all night.
About a girl he's paying him, and how he pays girls to love them.
I ask her who got a heart, cause damn that nigga lucky.
Yeah, it was very good in Roxanne, but at least that's almost very upbeat, which saved it a little for me. This is like Roxanne without a good beat.
Nothing wrong with that, every time I'm calling, she say she gonna call me back.
And without any personality. This is the most boring song we get, and now we have something I never have to think about again.
Expect me to talk about this song in December, that's what I'm saying, cause yeah, this is definitely bad enough for being on a year-end worst list.
I don't know why this is still in top 20.
She wanna fuck with the rules. She wanna fuck with the rules.
Here's probably really the stupidest song in the top 20 at the moment.
Seriously, I swear, like, how is this not dropped out yet? Yeah, if you didn't know, a few years ago, Proximus say you really say, oh, what do you call it?
Oh yeah, an eponymous album.
Yeah. I haven't listened to it yet. There's another eponymous album that has two songs in the top 10, which I have listened to, but we feel like it's way higher. Yeah, this is probably the most boring song I've ever and let the party go.
So I can land on that dick. She said tricks for kids, she don't fall for the tricks.
Yeah, I get why someone may jump to this. At least it's not more upbeat, and as he hasn't got that bad production, but my god, this course is so brain dead. Like, seriously, what does that even mean? Like, really? So she says, adds almost nothing to the song. The interesting part is this song.
Let me take you to the candy shop, show you all I got.
You see, I would call out before, but he actually made the original song, so I don't know, this song just changed it so hard. Oh yeah, and Roddy Rich is apparently on this.
I can take you out of here, where I fuck a jet fare. Versace Hotel with Versace Row.
Where though? Seriously, he has nothing to the song. Like, this song just bores me out. Probably won't miss there are some releases here and it's the party go.
Hey, at least it helps this song to sort of give me hate, you know? Let's get some one from the place, something bad.
Bad guy.
DJ Khaled!
Come with me, leave all of your things, yeah. You can stop at Gucci, stop at Louis V,
yeah. Yeah, this song isn't really that good to be fair.
So sweet on Janine, Rolls Royce black in hidden heels, bags full of $100 bills.
Like, I get why someone may enjoy this if they like it's nice something from, but for me this song just sounds too dumb. But you see, if you do can sing sometimes, he's actually made some pretty good songs when he sang, but this song is just so lame. This is, these vocals are really, 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 really dull.
Full speed, so volley Perrier. Come with me, leave all of your things, yeah. You can stop at Gucci, stop at Louis V, yeah.
Like, does he even care? You see the most, that's it, Spanish thing you can say. At least in me, you can argue that he's at least trying to do something. These looks like just a boring Gucci woman stuff that is so overused in music. It's just him laughing about how he's gonna spoil this girl. It's Calm Up, but it makes him just unintentional. So probably thinking, why did he do that?
If anything, Jake just sounds more bored than ever. I don't see why anyone could give him fun to start uplifting at home.
I'm so tired.
Touch my watch, why you want get dead?
This song should be way better than it actually is.
Do got the whack, no safety. Lauren, Stacy, Mad Mix, Brazy, who dip up niggas daily.
You see, I feel like I should like this song, because there's a lot of good about it. I have a gym type beat, it's quite soft and not really fashion, but I think how it sounds.
I don't know. When it asks in the interview room, I don't know. How many gal in the room, I don't know. Is that a gal in my coupe, I don't know.
And you know what, TMW actually doesn't sound bad, this song at all, really, will not.
Chef, cause he's irrelevant. Free throw, that's me in element. My young boys who free, no evidence. What if on me, if he need anything.
I think he brings a lot to this song for me. And it seems some really good. Yeah, the lyrics are completely awful.
I don't know. When it asks in the interview room, I don't know.
But it sounds really, really fine to me. And Dutchwell is probably this dumb person ever.
Yo, touch my watch, get dead up, shell up, come here, pick your friend up.
He's definitely the weakest part of this song, I don't care about it. But it's actually kind of off word.
Oh, off of this rap, move back, everything's dead up, Jenna, what?
Oh yeah, terrible.
I know, it's super lame. Not as lame as Drake from that last one, but it's so boring.
Is he sending for me? I don't know. What I'm wearing there, sell first week, I don't know.
Stormzy.
Looking for a hair shots, but the shoe don't fit. Can't flex on me with a boot on Drake.
Stormzy.
Come on, nigga, that's stupid shit. Come on, we all know that I'm stupid.
I'll say it. I love Stormzy of the song. He's generally great, and I'm not even joking. I don't know why, but like,
Like his favorite song, best I've had since like Rocky Bob. Or like Selfless Gang, he sounds Jimmy, like he cares. I don't know why, but whenever I hear him sing this part, I just impede him so much because even though he's never spoken about it, I'm just not famous right now.
Wait up, yo! Punch man's face off, one up, shut up, beef my boys, I run up, cop.
Like, I know this is a good song, but I just can't enjoy it. I don't know what it is. I can say it good on me, but I don't know. Nothing's not so good, so even though I really do this bad, so I can call me Yoko.
Hey, at least every other song in this top 20 is a song which I enjoy somewhat, so yeah, let's get to that.
Oh, this city's gonna break my heart. This city's gonna love me, then leave me alone. This city's got me chasing stars.
This is right, I like it some more. It's a decent little piece of music.
This song is fine, I like it a bit. But it's not perfect in any way, but I do understand this song and I accept this how it sounds.
Getting closer than I'm
with. This actually sounds pretty nice as an acoustic ballad. The guitars look really well and sound sexual. Actually sounds pretty good on this.
I remember mornings where my head didn't hurt.
And so really the only problem is that these lyrics, well not bad, but they are a bit confusing at times. Like, I think it's an era of poetry, and I mean, I did Sam Fletcher describing this city like this person, maybe she, I don't know, like,
she's always gonna break your heart.
I guess it works in context like, about maybe the thing going on the world this year, or maybe it's just sort of basically, they can go wrong and this doesn't take me in life. But they, I just don't really get the jokes too well.
This is not a song and for pop music, I really should have asked them much more than that. It's alright, I can't complain. Oh my god, why am I praising another Chris Brown song? My gosh.
Whoa, babe, everything you do is amazing.
I kind of like how Chris Brown is with this song, I'll be honest. He's insane in a way which I really enjoy over the street, and it's all pretty great actually.
Everything you do's amazing. Ain't nobody got you
go
crazy.
I do like the whole thing of this song. Yeah, I know that he's not the best singer, maybe he hasn't got the best Christmas, but I don't know, I do genuinely yes and is so much he's trying to be sincere and share this girl how he really feels. That is what I really enjoy. I just enjoy the whole sentiment about him going to this girl and just being honest. And I enjoy it. Yeah, young thug brings it down, but Chris Brown's voice, the way he sings. How would you just we just make like heart melt, you know? And hey, just ain't half bad either.
She don't need no hands or no pants. Do your dance, pop
the
rubber band,
did
the dance, make it
fast. It's a beat and fast in a way. I somewhat enjoy it, even though it's a bit repetitive. And the pre-chorus is very, very, very fast. You know?
I can put you on a flight. You know that a nigga like me can change your life.
Bit disoriented sometimes, but the rest is surprisingly solid in a way. I know this would be very controversial, maybe some isn't even that good to be fair, but I don't know, I like it in a way. It's right. It's fine. It's perfectly listenable. It's probably just some my shit music. Yeah, I got nothing good to it, but the song everything's pretty solid.
Biggest song in the top 10 right now. Yeah, I'm serious. Before it's ever made of these on Twitter, you were wrong.
You don't get two fucks, but I still want that. Your savage love. Your savage love, love.
I get. How did Jason Derulo of all people get ahead in 2020? I mean, seriously, I guess I understand that the internet barely comes to 40, but this is the number one hit. This is the biggest song in the country at one point. How, this makes no sense.
If I woke up without you, I don't know what I would do. Thought I could be single forever till I met you.
What was wrong with that? I don't actually hate the asshole.
In fact, I put this one spot below Rockstar.
Brand new Lamborghini, fuck a cop car. With a pistol on my hip like I'm a cop.
Yeah, this kind of shit just made this boom. The lesson isn't very impressive.
Yeah. Through the pain, dropped enough tears to fill up a fucking bucket. Going for buggers.
And Roddy Rich, I swear, there's absolutely nothing on this song. Seriously, Roddy. Or is this fair?
When I ran in the Suburban, it was a Cody, had a young nigga swerving. I got the mop, watch me wash him like detergent.
We know it's gone. I don't know, it sounds nice, and the baby does have a lot of charisma. He also has this really funny line.
Have you ever met a real nigga rockstar? This ain't no guitar, bitch, this a clock.
I know, just more and then a guy how gangsters are. And then saying, oh, I have a guitar. I have a gun. Like, I know, but it's so dark, but also really stupid. This song is quite dope.
Police can't catch me this up.
Brand new Lamborghini, fuck a cop car. With a pistol on my hip like I'm a cop.
But it's like, I just made it kind of fun, right?
It's not one of those nest quick milkshakes you get at the shop. Yeah, you can probably buy the best one at the doors, but you know what? It's quite cheap, but it's nice, you know.
And yeah, it's all right.
Baby, I hope that this ain't karma, cause I get around. You wanna run it up, I wanna lock it down.
But having a mini show in the song, I don't actually hate this song at all. I mean, like, it's dumb. It is super dumb. It's one of the dumbest hits of the whole year. It's one of them, cause like, there's some dumb hits. Yes, and the drop is kind of terrible.
La, la, la. You could use me, cause I still want that, you're satisfied.
But yeah, I don't actually hate this at all. I think even though this song is super obnoxious, it kind of plays on the beats, you know. And just to really, does actually sound pretty nice for this, dare I say.
Every night and every day.
He's not the best thing in the game, one, but I think it was in a way that was only so obnoxious that him rambling on actually adds a lot to what the song does production wise and in a way lyrically.
I just found out the only reason that you're loving me was to get back at your ex lover, but before you leave.
Then, about that, resets me absolutely nothing.
Savage love, did somebody break your heart?
I'm not joking, this is one of the dumbest song lyrically ever. What this is about a savage relationship, about two people who can't fall in love.
Every night and every day, I try to make you stay.
About a girl just gone through a breakup.
I just found out the only reason that you're loving me was to get back at your ex lover, but before you leave.
And he's trying to call for mom. I see a few bits of that sort of thing is actually about. But it's also about a could be in a relationship.
You don't get two fucks.
Also, I think this one has what people call dance monkey syndrome. But the last bit of the song is absolutely epic. I don't know why. This was the longest banner that we've got so far. Even the no deal point fell off. Yeah, I can tolerate it.
His life is good. His life is good. His life is good. His life is good. His life is good.
Rain on me.
I don't know why, but I feel like she just talked about new Missy Gaga songs in the video. Oh yeah, I just did. Oh well. Yeah, this was good. Like, really good. The production, it sounds really great. It's a retro feel, swear. It also sounds very different to normal music. And Ariana Grande works really well in conjunction to it, surprisingly. Anyway, she sounds amazing on this, my gosh. Anything about this song is just so vibrant and enjoyable, and I really enjoy just a different feel of it. I'm so happy that they got gold able to get ahead again, because this is absolutely amazing. I think this song even good kid, what am I doing with my life?
Bitches calling my phone like I'm locked up nonstop. From the plane to the fucking helicopter, yeah. Cops pulling up like I'm giving drugs, nah. I'm a pop star, not a doctor.
Yeah, I know, it's never taken to get hard song. Yeah, I know, it has to be awkward, very cool.
Crown in my hand and I'm really playing keep away, shit don't even usually.
No, I didn't want to say this, but I actually kind of really like how it sounds.
Yeah, last year I kept it on the tuck, ayy. 2020, I came to fuck it up, yeah.
Oh yeah, Drake says I'm actually really good, actually. Hey, that's not a lot of charisma. I know why, but like, even if it sounds very weird and coarse, I get mesmerized with what he says and how fast he's spitting these bars. It's also really entertaining to him. Go at it. I don't know why.
And I'm troublesome, yeah. I'm a pop star, but this shit ain't bubblegum.
Yeah, again, there's nothing in it. I don't know if people don't like this song, but for me, I find it to be really just heartwarming. I don't know why, but like, remember what you're doing with? I'm just happy.
Yeah, yeah, go and get your friends, we can sneak away. Yeah, I keep a, like I keep the faith.
I'm just smiling. I feel that act like I'm super cool. I don't know why, this song isn't that cool to be fair.
Pulling up like I'm giving drugs, nah. I'm a pop star, not a doctor.
I mean, what's this song about? About Drake's now amazing success and how, like, yeah. About how Drake's amazing success, but people accept him to be super straight.
Busy at the crib cooking salmon with the lobster. If we talking joints, it's just me and David Foster.
I'm sorry guys, I know that you will hate this one, you're gonna get away, but like, I think this is a good tier. Like, what? This song is awful.
Why?
Have the heavens opened.
Chose my jamless youth for a chain and give it to a sweet one called that Maya Jama. Giving out gifts like Santa, sipping on Santa. I used to do lean and wop.
I never liked the heavy one and Drake on UK drill form together. Especially not this scene after heavy one got his first Billboard hit. I don't know how he was a feature in that song. Now I'm going to talk about David Rush, yeah, but I like it. It's got a good beat. Some pretty air lyrics, but
love my green, I'm trying to get strong.
Remember guys, to eat your fruit and vegetable all the time. But the phrases were memories, listen, my listen. But the phrases what I get mesmerized with. I don't know why, but there's a serious, super entertaining.
Drops, no cuss, pull up in a new plate, then she might just. She went trying to move bait when her eyes locked, new tints on her coupe, that's a head loss.
It's a very good song, I recommend you check it out at some point. You really probably have a way to get some billboard.
I love pose with a ting for the picture. You man should've bust that ting already. You man love hezzy. Yeah, can't back chat to the prezzy. You know.
After this song, it's not as good, but I still like it a lot.
See, was he? Nah. The man weren't ready that what? 1942 hits my system. Man, get way too frosty, buzzy. Girls, when
I said B. It's just some drill beat, but I know. It's just like some punch. You know.
That loves me, I swear that touched me. I never even drive no whips I own, so they all look way too dusty.
It sounds great, and yeah, Drake is saying again the normal bars. There's some really saying nothing interesting. Yeah, you're asking one. In fact, this was actually a freestyle.
So far up starting real, got no connection. I'd have run through so much Scottish notes, couldn't care about no recession.
Which, my god, these. This is way too amazing.
Boy, don't make me have to rise my rifle. Man, try to send some young boys for me. Don't make me have to ride by high school.
It is an effort between Drake, and he has a case of the beat really well. This is just nice, listen. And now, Heady Wonders good as well.
Now it's dripping me like I'm canoeing. Time just flying on. I'm just trying to see this life thing to my juvies.
So I have been the Heady Wonders. One fan, both is still pretty bad. But hell, if you need some more from like this, might you can take them all this stuff.
It was a work for the jeans were boot, like putting that work we had ever been smooth and
this song is a banger of a half, that's all I can say. This way, this is just void again. Now, this is the first thing I mean, void it, but this just sounds like void it again to me. Falling out of love again. Void it was one of my favorite songs that she charted in 2019. But this is really nice. Yeah, sure, I like it more than this, but I do enjoy this. But again, this is just Void It Again. Not to mention the drops are exactly the same. Really, I'm actually kind of upset that we girl can't make something pretty original. Yes, there is added vocals by way which do spice it up a bit and make it a lot better. And I do generally like her parts in this song. But I don't know, I just rather listen to Ride It than this, to be fair. This one isn't bad, but this means something, I think. I don't know about you. About an extra, I have no idea. Overall, I like this song, but I just avoid it and get rid of this song. I'm sorry, it can't make me great here.
Make me fall in love and you can keep me forever. Make me fall in love and you can keep me forever.
Thank you, Lord. You win.
This type of love don't always come and go.
Fine, I admit, I like Juice WRLD. I like Mrs. Swords, it's not all of them, except for Armageddon Dangerous and Fine China. I like him as complete worst, and he was me one of my favourite songs of all time. I genuinely love what this guy used to do, and I was just distraught when he died. This is far from my favorite song from my album, but you know what? I still really love it.
in nothing. I pray to God that he make me a better man.
She says that what was Xavier was to be releasing after he died, that's been pretty solid. This isn't just a precious album, and even it made me tear up, but I couldn't lie and say that it was all bad. My gosh, this is a sort of banger.
This type of love don't always come and go.
I said the drop, it is so amazing. It sends energy in the best way possible. It hypes me up, it makes me feel great about myself, not gonna lie. So, even though it's produced by what they say that's one of the worst producers in the world, I do generally like this song on some level. And like, even the lyrics are good.
I reckon shit, it seems like I perfected it. I offer you my love, I hope you take it like some medicine.
Heck, even when it's so good, it's about how Jason wants a girl that he really likes. And he's scared to ask her out because, like, this love doesn't happen forever. He feels a strong connection, so I can relate with completely, and I know I actually really enjoy it.
Maybe one day I'ma stand for something. I'm thanking God that he made you part of the plan.
Versus the song. Me, I'm surprised just how well the song holds up. Maybe at least it sounds somewhat finished in G-Soul Boy, I'll get it that. Overall, I like this song.
But really, it's a joke that makes this song so amazing. My god, it's so great, oh my goodness.
Oh my god, how am I going to justify this opinion?
I'm just right here dancing around to the rhythm that you play, feel you breaking my heart.
I know that this is apparently like the worst song in the world at the moment, and apparently everyone hates it. The thing is that I've loved this song ever since it came out.
You can do whatever, I'll be here forever, spinning round inside this room.
I'm not ashamed to say what I give this a great film. To me, this is what you get if you manage two of my favourite songs from last year. I'm so tired and minded and kind of put them together, and this is like a worst case scenario output.
Won't you come on over? I'm a sucker for you.
That thing, this song isn't that great necessarily, but I just love the effort put into this song. I know why, but I find this to be one of the most chill songs on the list. I know I'm saying that a lot with you, but I know, I just love this chorus.
And I'll be singing la 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 la.
Maybe the movie was boring or generic, I just call it relaxing and calm. And the vocals really work over the beat of this song in my opinion, and it adds to a pretty great job.
La 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 la, you're breaking me.
Yeah, this drop, it's nothing amazing, but I find it to be pretty calm and relaxing and actually really interesting to listen to. I don't know why I love this chorus so much. He just thought it was just about a breakup, but
another, I don't even bother, I could do it all my life.
Whenever I hear this, I feel so happy. Happy, it's so weird, but I really enjoy listening to this. The choruses are nothing special, but I do generally find them to be good in case I like this guy's voice.
Tell me if you wanna, cause I got this feeling.
I don't know what it is, maybe it's just the old tune, but I just feel so relaxed. Yeah, he say nothing interesting, but I just love his rambling along. I know this is going to be this controversial opinion in my system, and probably shouldn't even really view YouTube if I'm gonna say, yeah, I like something like this, but you know what? Screw it, it's my opinion.
Yeah, I should probably just end this video here, no need to go on. Bye!
Hey, don't you know I'm walking away? Now I'm in my own space, baby, you know I ain't waiting for you.
Yeah, like I said earlier, I find it really cool how Education can just make a song and be one of the biggest songs in the country. And this is why you might feel it hit by him this year.
Big beast when it comes to the lyrics. Me, I do this thing on the mic with no gimmicks. Came a long way, I was serving in no civic.
It's just so energetic. It pumps me up even more than some of the other songs on the list. I don't know what, when we hear this, This is what Jenny Oaks is. Oh, she's so much fun. Hey, remember last year when I said that Mabel was a mediocre artist that I didn't care about? Yeah, I think I kinda need to take that back actually. I thought it was amazing this how Mabel has turned around her career in 1 year.
I want a boyfriend, so put it on me. I'm looking for a man who can take that heat.
Last year she made something from annoying to kind of air. And I don't know, I simply like as enjoy her. Then yeah, in 2020 she's really improved. One of her songs is actually Age and is a pretty big contender for my best list. And this is great as well.
Say, only one thing to say, babe, you know I ain't waiting for you.
I just, this how she sounds. I don't know why, but I think this song is absolutely amazing.
Say,
so you see, Jenny says that she's having fun, even her lips are pretty serious, aren't they, right? Just imagine her just passing to this and like having a time of her life. It's honestly fantastic, that's how I like it.
I have a direct, don't mean that I'm live, but live and direct means I'm building a vibe.
AJ Tracy is just really good, honestly, and this is no joke. I don't know what, but I feel like his rapping's even better than him, didn't he? He sounds genuinely amazing.
Down, then I'll spot you, water you, show you sun, never block you. If no one's back in your beef, then I've got to.
Not gonna lie though, his ears are kind of nonsense. Like, complete nonsense. Like,
8-piece, 8-P, come and get me, set beast, curl it in from a set.
Seriously, what was he thinking with these bars? But to be fair, nonsense in that lead doesn't sound that bad anymore. And this is also pretty great as well.
Hey, I'm very waiting for your next album, AJ. Come on, release something, please. I need a new album from an artist since that I care about. Please, this is not insomnia.
This is the part where I tell you I'm fine, but I'm lying. I just don't want you to worry.
And now back to my part where I praise you for anything at like radio, because I love a rapper from the latter half of a decade.
Talk my pain with my wishes in a wishing well.
Yeah, no, but in reason, I actually think this song is pretty great. Not only has it got some pretty good production and it sounds pretty nice, I just read up the lyrics.
Like an anvil, Frankie got me itching like an anthill. Drugs killing me softly.
She'll a bit generic, but I don't know. I have the idea of just looking down at a wishing well, hoping I can get better, but he knows that it can't, and doesn't let this really speak to me. I know, he knows that he's in the solid life, but he's just trying to get better from this job paid season, something which I have gotten through a lot of time.
I still try even though I know I'm gonna fail.
And this is seeing him looking down and like he's saying okay, okay, but he knows that he's lying.
This is the part where I tell you I'm fine, but I'm lying. I just don't want you to worry. This is the part where I take all my feelings and hide them, cause I don't want nobody to hurt me.
Really, I've done that so many times, lying to myself to make me feel better. And trying to tell people, well, you'll be okay because you just don't want to worry, really speaks to me.
But if I keep taking these pills, I won't be here. Yeah, I just told y'all my secret. Yeah.
Well, see, I just have a general feel this song is absolutely great. It just sounds amazing as well. Yes, your production could have been better. But I don't know, I think it works for the minimum setting of this song. Honestly, I just love this song. I feel like you don't even deserve this song, to be fair.
Watermelon sugar high, watermelon sugar high, watermelon sugar high.
I don't know why, but this song is way too fun to be a top 10 team this year.
Okay, by the way, I hate this video. So you know what? Here's some Rap 19 Joey Wolfman videos, because why not?
Strawberries on a summer evening.
Because like, come on guys, like, how, like, why on earth would you even I've listened to it 20. The world is at the most boring it's ever been. Yet some fun song about eating wolfman is
getting washed away in you. Breathe me in, breathe me out.
One of the biggest songs in the world right now. I would be mad, but this song is so amazing, which I don't even care. I just want to dance for it.
I don't know if I could ever go without.
How are you supposed to have this great song recently? And even if this is not actually my least favourite, I do see this song smirks a lot. He says, this song has a great summer vibe, that's why I enjoy it too much.
It's I just wanna taste it.
But remember how good this song is? It wasn't able to beat The Weeknd. Fine, Abel, you win. I probably didn't want to put the song as number one for 2 seasons in a row, as The Weeknd is probably the most generic artist to love, but I just couldn't. I mean, everyone has a song. I have a song, you have a song, even your mum's, sister's, ex's, cat's, ex-boyfriend loves this song. I mean, why not? It's a banger. So this song is way too good. Yeah, I know, it's a bit weird how I thought this song is so wintry. Yeah, it's middle of summer and this one's not still in the UK top 20, but what is on this is, I actually don't mind. It's definitely better than the other song I wouldn't fuck up last year. This one's actually pretty great. Weekend since this month is amazing, yeah, you already know that. Oh, I'll think it more in December because this is definitely going to make my best list. Overall, this has got the best song ever. 69 out of 100. Hell yeah! Anyway, I'll see you next time. I'm going to do the scoring of this top 20. Bye!